Porzingis has talked about channeling his inner Kobe Bryant, his idol. Is he developing faster than we thought? I mean,
To me, he's right on schedule. Okay. I think what we're seeing is a lot of there's more opportunity for him. Right. That's not a knock on Carmelo Anthony, right, but when you have a player Carmelo's caliber, he's going to use a certain amount of your possessions. You get him out of there, all right, we have these extra possessions running around.
You got to give him to somebody.
You got to give him to somebody. You might as well give him to your best player. So now he's being able to kind of stretch his legs in a way that before he wasn't able to. And then also, I don't want to underplay this. The play of the rookie, Frank.
Frank, what's his name?
Still can't pronounce your last name.
We get it. We're getting closer and closer.
He's been a big part of the Knicks turnaround over the last three games, wins pretty much. And again, don't want to take shots at other people, but this is what it looks like when you play with a real point guard who's looking for guys.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry, Byron, but Amin, did you just praise Phil Jackson twice? Did you just say that he was right to get Carmelo out of there for Porzingis' development and that he drafted the right guy?
We never said, oh, you got to build around Carmelo. We said, if you're going to get rid of Carmelo, you have to do it in a certain way with some decorum in class. When it comes to the point guard, the young man is playing very well, but there are other guys. There are other guys that they probably could have
jumped in.
Dennis Smith Jr. wouldn't have been bad either.
I just had to call him on that.
But I will say this. I got to give Meade a lot of credit because he said on this show a few weeks ago that Porzingis would be an all-star and should be an all-star starter. So I got to give him big-time credit for that because I said he was out of his mind. You're looking like the GM that you used to be back in the day.
Oh, man.
So I'm going to give you all the props because right now that man is balling. He is balling.
I like that, Byron. You could be a GM. In our eyes, you were a GM, maybe, sort of. Another young player on the rise, literally in this case, is Andrew Wiggins. Ooh. Look at what he does to poor Josh Richardson of the Heat last night, late in the fourth quarter.
That's an and one.
That hurts, right?
That's an and one.
Look, I mean, we've talked about it. Team defense has not been great for the Wolves this season. Wiggins has been part of that problem, but he certainly has been trying to live up to that $146 million max extension he signed. He's averaging 20 points a game. I mean, Byron, are you convinced yet that he's going to pay this off, or do you need to see more?
I still need to see more, but I do like this about Andrew Wiggins. It's the fact that everybody was saying that they shouldn't have gave him all this money, and he has a chip on his shoulder. And that guy is going out and saying, okay, you didn't want to give me that money, or you don't think I deserve that money? I'm going to show everybody that I deserve that money. And right now, when you look at this young Minnesota Timberwolves team with Karl-Anthony Towns, who we know is a star, and you look at Jimmy Butler, who we know is a star, he is the go-to man.
Yeah.
Andrew Wiggins is their go-to man, and he's delivering big time every time. So right now, I want to see more. I obviously want to see more because this is a long season.
Yeah.
You know, it's a long year. Mm-hmm. I want to see. But what I've seen so far early part of this season, he's not only worth it, he might should be asking for a raise.
No.
Andrew, ask for a raise. I mean, yeah. Next week, though.
Ask for it now.
Ask for it now.
Life gets easier when you get better players around, right? Because the attention of the defense is divided. And so he's taking advantage of that. To me, when you talk about earning that money, he's got to get better defensively, not just in the I'm guarding you, but in terms of covering for my teammates, helping the helper,
team defense.
That's what separates an okay team with a good team, with a great team, and so on and so forth.
I mean, look, he had this great ankle breaker, right? Last night also, and this was an OT, I think, right?
Yes. That's what, and he got fouled on the play.
Right. Would have been a dunk. Should have been a dunk. I mean, look, to me, when I see this stuff and I see his aggressiveness, it's his motor, right, that we've kind of talked about or people around him have talked about. There's been a lot of reporting about this, about sort of where he
since
is,
he was in college.
Right? Yeah. And I see the motor in so many times, and I'm impressed by that. I want to call it out when guys improve, right?
Yeah.
You're not going to be perfect when you come in the league. If you improve on what we keep talking about, I like that.
He keeps
I want to see that. Let's see more.